Great to have you here with us in Georgia.
So happy to be here.
Thank you so much, and it's our privilege to have a conversation with you. At the same time, before moving to Georgia and your plans or your intro, we are really interested to be more aware about DMCC itself. You are more than 18 years a part of the organization. Yes. You reformed the various direction in your country and in this organization, but please tell us more about DMCC itself.
It's an initiative established by the government of Dubai. The focus was to attract commodity trade through Dubai and create a free zone to support that. Our focus has been on gold, precious metals, diamonds, colored stones, agri-commodities. We're also maybe not really known for this, but probably within the energy sector, DMCC is the largest free zone that represents the oil and gas sector and other energy products. So we're growing in that sector as well. It wasn't easy to start. We started very small, and DMCC could have disappeared during the global recession in 2008. We were about 1,300 companies at the time. Today we're over 16,000 businesses. So it's one of the best free zones globally. It's been ranked the top free zone worldwide 4 times in a row, and we're hoping we would achieve that for a 5th time by the FDI magazine.
Let's begin with the purpose of your visit. It's your first visit. It's, in my understanding, what I have searched, Ahmed, I might not be the best in this, but media is doing all the best in this regard, said DMCC's interest, yourself as a chairman and CEO of DMCC, it's the first time and first connection to Georgia. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, it's my first visit as well, and I'm learning. My view is we've managed to connect with very challenging regions around the world. You know, there are certain countries that we work with in Africa, and we have represented their businesses also in Dubai, whether it be diamond tenders or processing the teas that comes from Africa through our tea center and now our coffee center. When I think of Georgia, there is a strong relation between Georgia and the UAE. It's only 2.5 hours flight away. I can't ignore it. I can't ignore the fact that we could have a similar relation with Georgia like we do in India. It's not going to be exactly the same. Mm-hmm. For example, hydropower is one of your key energy sources here. In Dubai and the UAE, in the long run, we will be known as the solar energy people. Okay. Like we're investing a lot in that, and we're getting ready for when oil runs out. For me personally, I cannot overlook this opportunity. I don't know much about Georgia. Yet. I didn't do a lot of research. I'd rather come to the source here and see for myself, and that's what I'm doing here today.
Right today. The visit itself includes all sort of interests with government officials and with private companies, correct?
Well, whoever I can meet on this short trip. I do plan to visit again with my team and all that. I'm just I'm a curious person in nature, and what I'm seeing, I like what I'm seeing. I see there are signs that it's looking to be a competitive region, a competitive city, and to play on the global scale. And DMCC, Dubai, and the UAE want to be a part of that story.
While moving to my next question, you mentioned already that you will come here with your team. Does that mean that you're already scheduling your next working visit to
Georgia?
Well,
I'm engaging with them. I'm sending them feedback. You know, when we started DMCC, one of the main challenges was which commodity to start with. You know, should it be gold, should it be diamond, this or that?
Yeah.
And we had to be honest, we had to work with what we can achieve right now, what we can attract. So Dubai was known as a gold city. We capitalized on that. We attracted some gold refiners, and today we have one of the largest gold vaults in the Almas Tower. We have the Gold and Commodities Exchange. So we addressed that. When it comes to Georgia, We could have visited Georgia 10 years ago. Maybe we should have, but it's difficult. And for me, you know, there are certain headlines about Georgia, politics, these things. I wanted to look at the business aspect
the economic of it, side of it.
Economic side, and see where we can work together. That's my part of
the purpose.
Yes.
Could we be more specific about free economic zones, which is a core issue personally for you? Unfortunately, personally for myself and other business guys in this country, this system didn't work out here in my country. I'm not sure are you aware of the details, but it's a fact that we have legislation, we have a few free economic zones, but most of them are complained. But besides these complaints, Ahmed, what do we see is that the model is not working properly.
Well, not just like in football, not every football team is going to win and going to perform well. It depends on the people. It depends on what your product is. We have more than one free zone in Dubai. Not all of them are meeting their targets. DMCC has been really performing well. We refuse to give up. We focus on our core activity. It depends how it's managed, to be honest. And for us, we always benchmark. Not to other free zones in Dubai and the Gulf. We actually, as DMCC, we benchmark to Singapore, Hong Kong, and we make sure we're up to speed or better. Otherwise, you can't compete. I mean, the world is becoming really small. People know what services are available in other places. So if the free zones here are not providing a similar facility, similar speed of service to their members, the same way it's happening in Dubai or anywhere in the world, you're gonna get complaints.
Can I have a feeling that free economic zones might be an interest of yours in this country besides admitting energy, hydropower energy, and other infrastructural projects?
Look, for now, we...
Or it still depends on your survey.
No, for us, we're not here like, I'm not here to create a free zone in Georgia, but if that's a service or we can help in assisting them in creating a good free zone here and showing them what worked with us, by all means. I mean,
because this experience coming from DMCC,
yes,
which is combined with various things, and at the same time, it's admitted as one of the best global free zones worldwide. I think this experience should be shared, of course, in regards of business.
I don't want to assume. I mean, we also have experience, and at least myself with some of my colleagues, we've been part of the Gold and Commodities Exchange since 2005. It's been 14 years now. We run a tea center, we run a coffee center. Both have blending, packaging, storage facilities, a business center. We've established them in a custom bonded free zone. So it's more than just providing a free zone and talking about the tax-free license and setups and all these things. When we talk about DMCC today, we talk about a market that's represented by 16,000 businesses. Our target by 2025 to reach over 30,000 businesses.
You mentioned about gold, diamond, pearl. What I've searched is that you've been running all these directions and at the same time creating specific institutions, like international exchange, like specific trading zones and things like that. All of them are working, and by the end of the day, it was a real motto for the final institute. Does that mean that all these directions, what you have created more than 10 years, around 14 as you have mentioned, they're part of free economic zones and all the model what you have created within the DMCC and around itself?
Look, we don't take it for granted when we come up with an idea. It might not work. Mm-hmm. We have to give
it's
it
a business.
Our best. We have to try. You have to understand, Dubai is a new city. It's very young. I mean, 40 years ago, none of what you see today was there. the community changed, the mentality changed. Dubai is becoming more and more global as time goes along. And I feel Georgia is also going that way. It wants to be an international, it wants to play on the international platform. So
why not to be here and why not to be a part of it?
We will find synergies. I'm so sure about it. I don't really doubt it. I mean, if we're focused on commodities, things that are linked to shipping and logistics,
correct,
this should be
ports,
a strong partner here. So I know there will be something happening, if more than one thing, but at this stage we want to find out what synergy we can focus on and how to prioritize them.
Correct. Very good. Thank you so much.
Most welcome.
It was very interesting, and I hope to see you with your team for your next visit, and
yes,
let's then update how it's going on.
Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you.